What is going on, YouTubeverse? John Stanek from Johnny Radio here, bringing you another Viva La Vinyl classic album review, and it does not get much more classic than this, folks. The 1969 masterpiece, Tommy by The Who. Such an amazing album. I mean, it's one of the greatest concept albums of all time, one of the greatest double albums of all time. This was their fourth studio album and the one that really put them on the map, rightfully so, because just genius songwriting and storytelling by Pete Townshend, who had the idea. Actually, this was not the first rock opera that they produced. They did a mini rock opera a few years prior called A Quick One While He's Away, a song about infidelity that was 7+ minutes long. And then Townshend said, look, I want to try this in an album form. And just the audacity to do an hour plus album that tells a linear story about this deaf, dumb, blind kid, Tommy, who internalizes things in an amazing way and shows that he can become a pinball wizard and people are just amazed by him and then follow him like a messiah. It's just really an amazing story, a brilliant one when you think about it, and they pull it off. I mean, for my taste, I think towards the end of the album, it does get a little bit repetitive with, like, Tommy, can you hear me? And then some plot lines go a little bit away from the story, like Sally Sampson, for example. But overall, I mean, they really pull it off, and they pull it off beautifully with the music. I mean, just from the opening of Overture, you know you're in for something special. The way Pete Townshend's acoustic guitar, it just sounds so rich and full. And I think Townshend's one of the most underrated guitarists of all time. His rhythm guitar playing is just amazing on this album. The way that he just does those, like on Overture and on Sparks and Pinball Wizard, I mean, everybody knows that riff, and he just strums so fast and so cool. And then Keith Moon's drumming can never be overstated. I mean, this guy, it's like his style is so chaotic, but then so controlled at the same time. When you're listening to this record, no one else could do those fills the way that Moon does. You know you're listening to Keith Moon, and the production on this record, especially for 1969, like the late 60s, when I think of drum sounds, it's usually not good, but they got such a perfect sound. You feel like you're in the room with them on this album. And that goes for John Entwistle on bass as well. Roger Daltrey's vocals are just mesmerizing when he's singing. Of course, Pete Townshend does a lot of the vocals, which are great throughout the album, because actually Townshend's vocals are awesome, and it gives like the different personas their own voice throughout the album. So like on the song 1921, which I think is just a killer melody where they say, got a feeling 21 is going to be a good year. I just love the way Townshend sings that. But then Daltrey, man, on songs like See Me, Feel Me, when he's singing that so earnestly, you're like, yes, whatever you mean by that, see me, feel me, touch me, heal me. It is a very spiritual album. You know, the story aside, when you hear lyrics like that, or at the very end of this album, We're Not Gonna Take It, the song that builds up to this awesome driving climax of the people saying, listening to you, I get the music. It's like, yes, man, you feel it right here. And, you know, what I kind of like that it's left a little open-ended in the story as to what the meaning really is, like what Tommy's insides really mean, and how people misinterpret them. And there's some really dark stuff in this album as well. Like on side A, when he's being tormented and abused by his cousin and his uncle, I mean, it's some really tough stuff that's being tackled on this album, along with the fictional story. I mean, it's all fictional, but it becomes very real and very sad in places. And yeah, there's just so much to this album. It's so rich in the story, so rich in the music. Again, there are some things that I think could have been cut short and some things that come off a little weird, like the Fiddle About song and, you know, Tommy's Holiday Camp are just a little campy, for lack of a better word. But, I mean, come on. You've got Pinball Wizard on here. You've got Sparks, that song that, if you remember from the movie Almost Famous, when the kid finds his sister's vinyl records and he puts it on, just happens to be at that moment Sparks in the song. And just instrumentally, it's just such a cool jam that you're like, man, this is like, you do want to listen to it with the lights out and a candle going, because it really takes you somewhere on an amazing journey. It's such a great album. If I had to give this a grade, I couldn't give it a perfect 10 out of 10 for the reasons I mentioned before, but I give it a strong 9 out of 10, which means, I mean, it's a classic masterpiece in my book. Everyone should own it. If you haven't heard Tommy yet, what are you doing with your life? Go do so immediately. And hey, we've got a lot more time on our hands right now, so what better time to do that? And guys, listen, it's the Who Week here on Johnny Radio, so stick around. On Friday, I'll be giving my top 5 Who songs of all time. See if you agree with that. Let me know in the comments below if you agree with my review, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on Tommy. Thank you, guys, as always, so much for watching. I really appreciate you supporting this channel. And as always, Viva La Vinyl. So guys, thanks so much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and be sure to ring the bell for notifications so you can always see great quality content like you're seeing on the screen right now. Thank you so much for supporting Johnny Radio, and I'll see you soon.